गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। So yesterday we discussed about space complexity. Okay, and today we discussed about time complexity. So I'm waiting for other people to join. Okay. So yesterday we discussed about performance analysis. What is performance analysis? And then we discussed about the in performance analysis. Okay. So we discussed about the performance analysis. So what performance analysis means, the algorithm requires to complete the so for example, the algorithm is said to be efficient and fast if it takes less time and execute and consumes less memory space. Okay, less time to execute and consumes less memory space, we call it the performance analysis. So performance analysis will be calculated by using space complexity and time complexity. Okay, so actually what is space complexity? Okay, so here the space complexity of an algorithm is the amount of memory it need to run to its completion. Okay, so here space complexity calculated in two ways, that is fixed part and variable part. So I already explained yesterday. So fixed path means independent of instance characteristics, whereas variable path means space for variable whose size is depending on particular problem instance. Okay, for fixed path example, simple declaration, simple variable constants we call it as fixed path. For variable part we declared as array. In array we call it as example for variable part is array. Okay, so these three examples I already explained. So here just remember that here we have only the it do not take any initialization or for any other purpose. It will not take the for any problem. It will not take the for it the algorithm name. It will not take any unit of time. Just it will allocate for in this examples here. Here three variables are there, so each one carries one unit time. So the time, the space complexity for the algorithm is 3. Okay, see here in this algorithm, so we have two variables, I is there, n is there, and s is there. So total 3 variables, okay, 3 units. And for here a will run up to n, so a has n units. And for loop, so total we get the value is n plus 3. The complex, the space complexity of this algorithm is n plus 3. These three are each carries 1, 3 plus the t8 will run up to n, so n plus 3 is our time complexity for this algorithm. So in this algorithm, see here, three variables are there, a, n and return. So 3 units of time. Total this loop run up to n plus 1 times. So the time complexity, the space complexity of this algorithm is 3 of n plus 1 units. Already explained in yesterday class. So this is about time complexity. Next we move to the space complexity. This is about time complexity. Next we move to the time complexity. Okay, so just to see next slide, that is performance time complexity. See here the time complexity. So what is time complexity? Okay, what is time complexity? So here time indicates how fast an algorithm runs. Okay, so here the time complexity of an algorithm is the amount of computer time it needs to run to complete. Okay, so the time complexity means the time complexity of an algorithm is the amount of computer time it needs to run to complete. We call it as the time complexity. So here time complexity can be calculated by using compile time and the execution time. Okay, so can be calculated by compile time and execution time. So see here in this example, first we calculate the execution time. So so execution time. So now we calculate the T of P equal to execution time. Okay. So T of P, first we calculate the execution time. So execution time will be calculated by using the method we call it as step count. Okay, we call it as the step count. Calculated by the method step count. So what is step count? So in this we just see here step count in algorithm we have to count the each step in this algorithm. We call it as a step count. So what is the count is zero, we cannot take any counting. If the count is one, we will take one step for counting, or one unit of time for counting. Okay, so here in this step count we have some rules are there for algorithm headings. It will not take any value for algorithm headings. It will take the value as the count as zero for algorithm headings. It will take the count as zero. Okay, next one for brackets also, open bracket, close bracket also, the count value is zero here. And for expressions, if you are any expressions in this, we take as count value as one for expressions. And for any loops, depending upon the loop iterations. Okay, depending upon the loop. So in for loop iterations, the number of times the n value will repeat depending upon the loop. Okay, for loop statements, number of times the loop is repeating, that is depending upon the loop. Okay, so here we also see that for variable declaration also it will not take any count. Okay, so why we are using count here? To calculate the execution time, we by using step count method, we have to count the each line in the program. Okay, so if there any open bracket or close bracket, we will not give any value to the count is zero. If you are any declarations also, we will not take any count value. If the any expression is there, we will give count is one. For also return also, we calculate count. For initialization also, we are calculate count value is one. For initialization, count value is one. For declaration, no. Okay. For expressions also, we give value one. For declare, for initialization also, means initialization means some value give to. For example, x equal to 10. So 10 is initialized here. So in here we give the count as one here. Okay, for open bracket, close bracket, count is zero. Okay, so these are some rules for calculating step count. So first one, algorithm heading zero. For braces also we give value zero. For expression we give value one. For loop, depending upon the loop, depending upon its loop value. Okay, so it number of times the loop is repeated depending upon that. So consider the one example, then you will understand the. So see here in this example. So your heading is for heading. If we take a for heading, the count is already told you for the heading the count is 0. For left bracket count value is 0. See here. Then return, for return we have the count value is 1. For return or initialization the count value is 1. A bracket also 0. So the total execution time for this algorithm is 1 unit. So 1 unit of time it requires 1 unit of time. Okay, understand? Anybody has any doubt, please write a message. So I move to the another example. See the algorithm 2 here. For this heading also the count value is 0. For the brackets also count value is 0. See here, this is the initialization. For initialization purpose we are using count is 1. Okay. So this is the loop here. See here, I am writing the loop here repeated 1 to n. So the loop will repeated how many times? N times or n plus 1 times. So I am writing here the count value is n plus 1. Why I am writing here n plus 1? For example, see here, for I equal to 1, I less than 3, I plus plus. Okay. So initially I condition true, it will check the condition, that is 1 less than 3. So it will increment I. So another next step, it will go to the I value is 2. 2 less than 3, condition 2, then increment. Again, it will move to the I value increment by 3. 3 less than 3, condition false. So how many times loop repeated? Actually, I value is less than 3. So I value is 3. So I value less than 3. Okay. How many times the loop is repeated? First 1 less than 3, condition 2, 2 less than 3, condition true. Next it move to the another step, that is 3 less than 3. Then it come out of the loop. Okay, for example, I less than 3. Okay, next step. Here loop repeated 3 times. Next step, condition true. Okay, next step, the I value is 4. Less than or equal to 3, condition false here. So how many steps are there? Step 1, 2, 3, total 4 steps. So n value is 3, but value is 4. That's why I write here n plus 1. So after if the condition till the loop will repeated till the false condition occur. So it will check the false condition, then only it will come out of the loop. So in this example, for 1, okay, condition 2, 2 condition 2, 3 condition 3 increment, then 4 it falls. So total, when it will come out of the loop means whenever the condition is false only, then it will come out of the loop. So here that's why I write here n plus 1 times, because 1 means here the false condition occur, then only it will come out of the loop. Okay, then see here count s will count value is higher n, because n times the loop is repeated. For return we are writing here 1. Okay, for return we are writing here 1, here 0. So calculate the just you calculate all the values here. So what is the value here? 2n plus 3. So this is the time complexity of this algorithm. Okay, clear? Any doubt? Why I am writing here n plus 1 means the loop will repeat it n plus 1 times. Actually, the loop continues 1 to n, then false continue occur only, then again it will come into the check the condition. That's why I write here n plus 1. Okay, so total value is 2n plus 3. Okay, understand? This is the okay, so these two are very common examples. Now we move to the recursion. So in recursion, what is the count value? Just to calculate this, see this example here. Okay. Okay, see this example, see here. So see the algorithm here. See example. Okay. Screen is visible. Okay. Any queries, please write a message in chat box. So see the example here. So I want to calculate this algorithm for recursion. Okay. So here, see here in this example. This is the algorithm, the count value is 0. Okay, so here, see here, what is the count value here? If n less than 0, this is the expression. For expression also, we give the value 1. So here 1. Then inside this, there is a return statement. So return statement also, we are giving the value 1. So 1 plus 1 is 2 here. So what is this? What the value of this count? Okay, so see here, for better understanding, for example, same this example here, t of n equal to 2. Okay, when the when is the when this value is true? Okay, when this value is true, so when this value is true, what you write here, I don't understand. N less than equal to 0. Roll number 68. What is your doubt? Please write your doubt. Okay, n less than or equal 0, this is an expression. So for that, we are giving the value, count value is 1, and the return statement, we are giving count total value is 2. So here, see here. So here t of n, okay. So t of n equal to 2. When the value is 2 means If n equal to 0, if n equal to 0, I check the condition, then it will return the count value is 2. Okay, for this line, the count value is 2. For example, if the n value is not 0, if the n value is another case. So in this case also, first it will check these two statements. So that's why its value is 2 plus. How many times this loop will repeat? So this will move on to plus. This is the n minus time this loop will repeat. So here, so t of n equal to 2 plus into t of n minus 1 times it will repeat if n greater than 0. Okay. If n value is greater than 0. Okay. So if the n value is greater than 0, this 2 means it will check the n less than 0 on return value. Okay, plus it will check remaining case n minus 1 times. So the time complexity is 2 plus t of n minus 1. So here we calculate the time complexity by using a recursive method. Okay, so here, for example, here we are taking t of n here. Then if you take the n value by using, we are moving like, so here we are recursively solve this example. Okay, so see here I am writing this in a text box. So first we will take this as recursively by using recursive relation we calculate this time complexity for this algorithm. So 2 plus t of n minus 1. Okay, so for this if n greater than 0 only t of n minus 1. By substitute by using the recursive relation, so we are substituting the n value with n equal to n minus 1. By substituting n value in the above equation, n equal to n minus 1. So you will get the value here. What is tn value? Tn equal to 2 of 2 plus t of n minus 1. Okay. So we will get here 2 plus, okay, inside bracket. Actually, t of n is 2 plus t of, instead of n, we place n minus 1. So we get the value is n minus 2. Okay. So actually, t of n minus 1 value is t of n minus 1 value is substitute in this put n minus 1 value here by substitute n minus 1 value in this we get we write this value. Actually, t of n minus 1 is 2 plus P of replace n with n minus 1, then we get this equation. Okay, next see here, in this the 2 plus 2 total value is 4. Instead of 2 plus 2, I am writing here 2 into 2, okay, the same value as 4. You understand? 2 into 2. Instead of plus 2 into 2 plus t of n minus 2. Understand? Okay, 2 into 2 instead of that I am writing here as 2 plus 2 4 means I am writing here 2 into 2 by solving this in recursively t of n minus 2. Okay, now we substitute n equal to n minus 2. So what is t of n minus 2 value? Right here. Okay, what is t of n minus 2 value? So here 2 into 2 plus, okay, 2 into 2 plus inside brackets 2 plus t of n minus 3. N minus 3. Okay, understand? So see here, after substituting n minus, this is the value. Now we again write this 2 into 2, 4 plus 2, 6. Instead of 6, I am writing here 2 into 3, 6 plus t of n minus 3. Okay, instead of 6, I am writing here 2 of n plus 3. So why I am doing all these things means, if you're doing like this recursively in some cases, okay. Okay, so by repeating steps like this, we get finally we get the value as here. See here, for example, here 3, next it will come 4. Okay, first of all, it will after substituting here 2, then 3, next it will come 4. Here also 4 is there, and next 2 into 5 plus t of n minus 5. So this process will repeat until 2 into up to n value, 2 into n plus t of n minus n. So n value we are taking n minus n. Finally we are taking n value as, finally we are taking the t of n as n. So here, so 2 into n is 2n plus t of 0. So what is the t of 0 here? T of 0 is, in this example, t of 0 is 2. So the complexity of this algorithm is 2n plus 2. This is the final solution for this recursive algorithm. Okay, understand, or anybody has any doubt? Okay, clear. So see steps here. By in this way recursively we are calculating the time complexity of the any algorithm. In this way we have to calculate. Okay, why I am taking here t of n equal to 2 means here if n greater than less than is one expression, then it is the return. So we are taking count is here 2. So here why I am taking 2 means already it will check this condition. So 2 plus remaining the process will run up to t of n minus 1 times. Okay, so after that we sub by recursive by backtracking or by recursive algorithm we are calculating from n. We are here taking t of n value, then we have to calculate n minus 2, n minus 3 and so on n. After substitute n value we get the value is 2n plus t of 0, that is 2n plus 2. So this is the time complexity of this algorithm. Okay, clear? Any doubt, please write a message. So consider another example for time complexity. So after step count, okay, then we have see here in this I discussed what is how we calculate by compile time plus execution time. So execution time can be done by using the step count method or frequency count. We call it as a step count method or frequency count. Okay, so see another example here. So here I am using another example, sum of int, okay, a int a comma int n. Okay, I am taking a function name as sum, then so I am initializing with sum equal to 0 or s equal to 0. I am initializing s equal to 0. Okay, next I am taking one loop for I equal to 0, I less than n, I plus plus. Okay, so then s equal to s plus a of I. I'm summing the array elements. A of I. Okay. Then I will return S. Return S. So just try what are the count value for this. Just try for this for sum int of a. So declaration it will not take any count value. So here count is 0. For left bracket also the count is 0. Okay. For left bracket also the count is 0. Here count 0. For bracket also count is 0. So here some declaration is there. Okay, so for declaration the count value is 1. So how many times the loop is repeated? N plus 1 times, because it will check the false condition. After that then here the loop repeat n times. So here return count value is 1. So total value is 2n plus 3. same example I already explained you. Just I am repeating the example. So this is about time complexity. So tomorrow we will. So here we have two approaches for time complexity. One is frequency counter, step count. Another one is asymptotic notations. So so next class we will discuss it about asymptotic notations. Okay. So everybody understand about time complexity. Okay, today another session. Tomorrow we will meet. Anybody has any queries, please write a message in chat box. Thank you.